Broadcasting live statewide from the Civic Media Studios in Green Bay, this is Nightlight with Pete Schwabba, your inside source on everything entertainment from Wisconsin to Hollywood. And now, a guy who thinks chickens dream of one day being pot pies, Pete Schwabba.
Hey, welcome back to Nightlight. For hour number two, on this festive day in our state, it is National Wisconsin Day. We are no longer regional people. We've gone national. We have our own day, and we are celebrating it today with a show that is all things Wisconsin, almost all things Wisconsin. The Adam West segment was not Wisconsin. Everything else is Wisconsin. We're broadcasting state live from City Deck Landing here in Green Bay at our WGBW studios. Great to have you with me on a Thursday night. If you still want to answer tonight's question is, what do you love most about our state? What do you love most about Wisconsin? We've gotten some great texts already. We'll get to one right now. This is Steve again from the 920. Being in the Florida Keys for the past 2.5 years, the two things I miss most is Wisconsin cheese and the summer sausage made from our dairy cattle and white-tailed deer. The family-owned meat markets and cheese factories are truly the best in all 52 states. Happy National Wisconsin Day. Thank you, Steve. Happy National Wisconsin Day to you, too, and for all your texts. You always have great texts. From our dairy cattle and white-tailed deer. I thought that read for a second, Conrad, like you guys lived on a farm or something. So I misunderstood. And you don't seem like the farmer type. No offense. I'm sure you could do it.
No, I definitely couldn't.
Have you ever milked a cow?
For field trips when I was younger in school.
Oh, that's like child abuse.
I guess it kind of is. Yeah, they made us do it. Well, I guess they didn't make us. They're like, if you want to, you can. I'm like, oh, why not? All my friends are doing it.
Oh, that's how they get you. Yeah. Everybody's doing it. I have never milked a cow on purpose. Okay, let's move on here because we got to get to some showbiz talk. As much as excited as I am that it's National Wisconsin Day, our state has plenty of artistic and cultural things happening. And I am about to welcome a fellow screenwriter and the producer of The Maggie Daun Show, Anya Esther, joins me now. Hi, Anya. Can we hear?
Hi, Pete. Hey. How are you doing?
I'm very well. How are you tonight?
Can you hear? Oh, there we go.
Yeah.
I'm good.
Do you have a, I'm going to ask you our question, Anya. What do you love most about Wisconsin?
I have been thinking about this question all day.
Oh, wow.
And I've got to say, I put a lot of thought into this. So get
I was going to say,
I'm
on
gonna
your
use
own?
A term. I don't know. Just staring off into the distance. I'm going to use a word that I think gets a lot of heat on the radio, but I want to use it for its like definitive, its definition term, which is I love the diversity of this state. And I don't just mean that in the sense that it usually gets used where it's like diversity of folks, which we do have.
Right.
But this state, and I think about it in the context of filmmaking, it's like, do you need a beach to shoot at? Do you need a big open body of water? We have that. Okay, but you don't have a mountain, do you? We do. Okay, but you don't have desert dunes, do you? We do at the, whatever it's called, the coal park. You don't have
right.
a dense forest somewhere. Oh, do we?
Plenty.
In spades, my friend. I just think about like everything you could look for. You need a city street. You need a rural road. You need someplace that gets hot. You need someplace that gets cold. You will find it all within this state in the course of a year, and not every other place can offer that. And I love that.
That is a phenomenal answer. And you're very right about that. Like, and it's interesting you say that because there's going to be a bill before the state Senate, I believe. There's a group in Wisconsin trying to bring back the incentives to make films here. And Minnesota has very aggressive incentives.
Go.
And I had a film that I would have had to go to Minnesota to shoot. Now, there was a writer's strike this year, and I'm doing this show. But if and when it ever happens, I would love to be able to do that in Wisconsin. And it bothers me that I would have to go to a state next door to make the movie. So we're going to have someone on from that group next week here to tell us all about what those guys are doing. So that's a great answer.
Yeah, I'm excited to hear what those guys have to say because the whole time that I've I don't know exactly what year the incentives went away. My understanding is it's attached to Public Enemies and Johnny Depp. It's always Johnny Depp who does something to ruin it for us, right? Right? But I would love if we started telling people from outside of Wisconsin just how cool it is to shoot here. I think about all the films that are supposed to be based in New York that they go up to Toronto to shoot. And I think, okay, but why go to Toronto? Come here. We have everything and it's cheaper. And I'd say, you know what? We're maybe even nicer. So,
and we have better accents than Toronto. I don't know if I'd push
that statement. That might get me in hot water, but way better. So
when you said, I'm going to use a word that I'm not sure I should use in the radio, I thought you were going to, well, I thought maybe it was going to be a cuss word, but I just thought of this today. When people say right all the time, like they'll finish a sentence and they won't even give you a chance to answer before they say right. And people will do it instantly. Like 3 or 4 days ago, last weekend, I'm talking to someone and she says, so the other day, right? I'm like, yeah, I'm with you so far. You haven't stumped me yet.
You don't know.
It's unbelievable. Like, I think it's like when people don't know what to say, but you're a writer. So I would imagine you're pretty economical with your words. Would that be accurate?
You know, I think I am when I'm the one who has to type them out. But when I'm talking, it's everybody else's job to listen. So I think I just throw things around, right?
Oh, that's a great answer. So
something like that.
You have a new gig or a more expanded role. Can you tell us about it here at Civic Media? Or can't you?
For a split second, you said you have a new gig. And I was like, what am I being voluntold? Yes. So Maggie, the Maggie Daun show, I'm so excited to finally say we're moving from just before your show from we were at the 6 to 7 hour. And then we took some time off to recombobulate. And when we come back in 2 weeks, we're going to be from 2 to 4 in the middle of the day. I'm going to be there with her. It is going to be an absolute powerhouse of a show. Every day, I think every day we're going to hit it out of the park. So you got to come listen to make sure we do.
I absolutely will. I'd love to have Maggie on this show just to kind of have her talk about it. And I saw your email. I will invite her when the time is right. But that's exciting. And that's a lot more work for you, though. Is that going to take away from your screenwriting time or your free time or what?
Free time. I haven't heard the name free time in a long time, but you know, I am of the mindset that as a screenwriter, you have to be doing things that are not writing, that are not just talking to people about writing. You have to be meeting people and doing things because that's what becomes your characters and your plot. And I have already met many characters through radio. So I look forward to doubling how many characters I'm meeting on a daily basis.
Yeah, there you go.
Over the course of forever as Maggie Daun show runs.
Oh, that's a great answer. So are you a lifelong Wisconsin resident, Anya?
I am. The only time I've not lived here is for 3 months in 2021, where I worked for a terrible, terrible summer camp up in the Poconos Mountains.
Oh, wow.
And that taught me all I needed to know to come back here and work here instead. Yes.
The Poconos will never have their own day. I can pretty much guarantee that. I know people. So what are you writing right now? What is your new, I think we have a delay. Sorry about that. I don't know if our stream is, messing us up here, but, what are you writing right now, Anya? What are you working on? Anything exciting?
I think it's something exciting and I apologize if there's a delay. It's almost certainly on my end. I'm writing a script that I'd like to have written and shot all done by Halloween of this year.
Wow.
Because I've learned about the Halloween film festivals and the you know, it's just an entirely different. I haven't made a lot of horror films, so I rarely have anything to submit to those. And a story came across my feed that inspired me to write something. So I'll leave out names, but a company that sells body lotions has received a lot of flack because people found that after using the body lotions that they sold, they were finding more male wolf spiders in their home.
Oh my gosh.
And people started writing these terrible reviews of this lotion. Like, I don't get spiders. Why are they here? Turns out two synthetic chemicals used in the lotion when mixed together you would never guess it or know what it smells like, but they smell exactly like the pheromones of a female wolf spider. So this lotion is attracting a very angry young male wolf spiders into people's homes where they find just lotion and not the beautiful spider maiden they were promised. So I have a script that revolves around someone giving essentially a lotion like this to an enemy who thinks they might be their friend, and some sort of chaos ensues as whatever creature it is takes over the house. That's the idea so far. TM, 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 don't steal it before I can write it.
That's a real thing? That's a real, like, if you told me you just made that up, that would be a good horror film, but that's a real thing?
It is. I'll send you a link.
Oh my gosh, that sounds like a nightmare.
That's a real thing that happened, and it's from that that I'm extrapolating.
Oh,
it is. It is. All these women, you know, they'd be putting on this beautiful lotion to smell nice and feel nice. And tick, 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 here comes Mr. Wolf Spider. Hey, where's my girlfriend? Not here.
Oh, you know,
I don't know if wolf spiders bite, but I imagine they do.
Are they the big ones?
In my nightmares about them.
are wolf spiders the big ones or are they smaller?
They are. They are. I think luckily the males are a little smaller, but okay. When I saw a wolf spider, it was like this big, like two hands together, those legs sticking out. Very scary stuff.
Oh my gosh, that is awful. What is that going to be, a short or a feature?
You know what? I'm thinking a short that I put out there and say, hey, would you like to see this as a feature? I don't know. I've been told that works sometimes to get movies made. So I'm thinking that route, maybe.
Okay.
But a short start.
That is really cool. Well, I wish you luck on that. I'm always always fascinated by what you're up to. Did you know, Anya, that it is rapper Lil Poopy's birthday today? Can you hear me?
Did you say Chris Farley's birthday?
No. Well, it is Chris Farley's birthday. It's rapper Lil Poopy's birthday. There's a rapper named Lil Poopy. This delay is so funny because the look
not,
I'm getting
not
from
not familiar with that artist, unfortunately.
Okay. Let's see if we can find some Conrad. We can play ourselves back into a break. Hey, Anya Esther is here, everybody. We're going to talk about movies and TV with Miss Esther. And that's coming up next on Nightlight with Peach Wabba on the Civic Media Radio Network. Got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it. Moving so phenomenally. You're more like the way we rock it. So don't stop. And under the lights when everything goes. Nowhere to hide when I'm getting you close. When we move. Welcome back. Celebrating National Wisconsin Day, what is the thing you love most about our state? You can let us know by texting on the phone number or the app. The phone number is 844-96-PARTY, 844-96-PARTY. But it's even easier on the app. Just click on any station because we're on statewide and hit the text icon and you will be interacting with us. And we love that. So Anya Esther is with me. And we are talking, she is an aspiring screenwriter, a radio producer. She's kind of does everything. We just got a text, Anya. I'll read this to you. This is from the 608 and someone I think you know quite well. His name is Chris Casper. He says, Anya is a statewide treasure. Look at that.
Aw, thanks, CRISPR. Nice? CRISPR, Chris Casper. I
you
didn't mean
call
to
him
do CRISPR? That, but there we go. And I truly didn't mean to. I truly,
that's a great nickname, actually. I think you might've started something there, but.
So sorry, Chris.
And then I asked for this, so I have to read this. This is from Papa Rico, the 608. This is Conrad's dad's joke. So Conrad, you might recognize this. Maybe Anya will recognize this. Okay. We'll see. But there's four guys going down the road in a camper. One is from Wisconsin, one from Illinois, one from Iowa, and one from Idaho. When all of a sudden the guy from Iowa starts throwing a bunch of corn out the window and the others are like, what are you doing? He says, I don't worry about it. We have plenty of corn in Iowa. After a little while longer, the guy from Idaho gets up and starts chucking potatoes out the window. He says, don't worry about it. We've got plenty of potatoes in Idaho. Not long after that, the guy from Wisconsin gets up and throws the guy from Illinois out the window. That is just blatant disrespect. Did you hear that
but
joke?
But is it unearned disrespect? Is it unearned disrespect? That's the problem.
Here's my problem is I'm a transplant, and I grew up the first 12 years of my life in Chicago, in the city, moved up to rural Marinette, Wisconsin, went to high school there. Somehow I ended up back there in my adult life. I never thought that would happen. Glad it did. So when I'm here, I'm an annoying Illinois person. And when I'm in Illinois, I'm this cheesehead. So I'm a man without a home. And I don't think it's fair. Truly. And you know what, Conrad? You and your dad and I are going to have words if we ever meet, because I've had about enough of his garbage. That's great. Thank you for sending that joke, Papa Rico. And not taking credit for it. He says it's a Conrad's dad's joke. God, Conrad knows everybody on the text line. He's sending out like a... Yeah. Okay. So, Anya, let's get down to some movies and TV, because that's what we do here. What have you seen? Have you seen any of the Oscar movies?
So I haven't seen anything more of the Oscars list since the Oscars list came out, though I've kind of got my priorities straightened out. Have to watch Zone of Interest, clearly. Have to watch American Fiction. And I, you know, I'm a big person for all the shorts. So at some point I'll go through all those short documentaries, short animated, whatever else they have up.
Nice.
As far as watching stuff, I'm kind of in a not retro, but I'm kind of looking back. I'm kicking off rewatching The West Wing, and I'm going to start The Newsroom soon. Just kind of going down, I guess, an Aaron Sorkin, you know, rabbit hole somehow.
Yeah.
So those are great. Otherwise, TV, haven't started anything other than Ted Lasso. I'm finally getting into the Ted Lasso world. I put it off until they finished that show, and now I'm starting off at series one, as the Brits would call it.
Nice. So you've got a whole series in front of you. Let me ask you something. How far into Ted Lasso are you?
I'm about halfway through season one.
Okay.
So I'm still new. I'm learning all this new football stuff, but
right.
Not far enough in to talk spoilers for sure.
Okay. So here's my issue with Ted Lasso.
Go for it.
I'm a writer. Okay. I've never won an award for writing, but I've sold some scripts, had a decent amount of success. I cannot stand shows where it makes no sense. Like Ted Lasso is fuzzy. Oh. It's funny. It's kind of sweet. I get why it's so popular. It came out during COVID, although that doesn't explain Tiger King. But Ted Lasso, I get it. And it's funny. And the writers are phenomenal. They're award-winning writers. One of them was on Modern Family. Others, they have great track record. But that would never happen. A guy who won a national championship in American football would never go coach a soccer team in a sport he knows nothing about in England. And the way they explain it is preposterous. It's like, oh, no, she wants to sink the team. I get it. But he wouldn't do that. And then one of the excuses he has to give his wife space. Okay, get a different apartment. You know, move to another state. You don't move across the pond and coach a sport you don't know anything about. Sorry, Anya.
Pete,
I got all
you underestimate. You underestimate the power of a bad enough ex-wife. I guess maybe she was across the pond. Where again, I'm not far enough into the show to know, but
okay,
you underestimate the power there.
I don't think I spoiled anything for you, and thank you for putting up with my rant. It is a funny show,
you do
get into it. you said you saw American Fiction? What did you think of that?
No, I haven't. It's on my list.
It's
probably the delay. There's just so many good films. You know, I think there were certain things left out of the Oscars noms this year, Greta Gerwig, but some other things. I won't get into that. But I now have my priorities. I've just seen such good reviews from people I deeply respect that aren't even necessarily film reviewers, but just people in my life saying, you have to see Zone of Interest. You have to see American Fiction. So those are at the top of my list. As far as things to see.
I haven't seen Zone of Interest. I think I've got two left to see. That's one of them. And I hear it's phenomenal. And I don't, the Greta Gerwig thing. Okay. What hurt even more, what was so crazy is that, like, okay, maybe Margot Robbie, she's done better acting work. That was kind of a fun role. Maybe didn't take all of her acting chops. But you could say the same thing for Ryan Gosling. He got nominated And Greta Gerwig put the whole thing together. Yeah. How is she not nominated? That's the real crime, is Greta Gerwig, and that Margot did not get nominated and Gosling did. That just makes no sense to me. So
my feeling is that so many of the nominations prove the thesis of the film that, I mean, America Ferrera's whole monologue, where you have to be perfect and better than perfect all the time. And it's just really disappointing to watch the Academy go, great idea. Let's do that. It's like, well, no, it's called irony, my friends, but that's the Academy, I guess. Yeah. I'm probably shooting myself in the foot for a lot of future things.
No, we'll bury this tape. We'll bury this tape. When you get nominated, trust me, I won't let anyone near this interview. So, and I do agree with you.
Thank you.
What about TV? Yeah. Anything? Oh, you said West Wing and Newsroom. Okay. That's
in the newsroom.
Cool.
Yeah, I've just decided those are workplace training for me now. Yeah. Those two worlds are kind of what this, you know, the earlier days stuff feels like for me. So, yeah, it'll be good training, I think.
Well, not that you need the training, because you're a rock star, and congrats on the promotion. And thanks so much for your time tonight. Always fun to talk to you. And let's do this again soon.
Soon. See you then.
All right. Thanks, Anya. That's Anya Esther from The Maggie Daun Show and an aspiring screenwriter and an overall rock star. Coming up in just a minute, we are going to talk about the new Giannis documentary and a little bit about what's going on with the Milwaukee Bucks from an insider. That's coming up next on Nightlight with Peach Wabba. This is the Civic Media Radio Network.
Did you miss what's hot from Wisconsin to Hollywood? Listen to the Nightlight with Pete Schwabba podcast on civicmedia.us. You can always listen through Spotify, Apple Podcast, or the Civic Media app. Take Nightlight with Pete Schwabba anywhere you go. Once again, here is your host, Pete Schwabba.
Welcome back. Happy National Wisconsin Day, everybody. We live in a wonderful state, and it deserves its own day. And great text tonight again. As always, we had someone from Travel Wisconsin on to help us celebrate. Conrad and I shared a couple stories. Maybe we'll get to a couple more. But right now, it is my pleasure to welcome to the show filmmaker and someone who does a lot of filming of the Milwaukee Bucks, Brendan T. Jones. Hey, Brendan.
Hey, how's it going?
Good. How are you?
Good. I'm a little tired. I've been traveling today, but when you hit me up, I'm like, yeah, let's talk about this documentary.
You're in New York City in a hotel room, as I understand it. And I understand it because you told
me. Yeah,
I
snuck down to the lobby.
Oh,
good. My mom hasn't been back in New York since the 70s. And so this Christmas, I was like, I'll take you to New York. So we're going to go see a couple shows and just wander around the city this weekend. But yeah.
Oh, good. You're a good son. Good for you.
Yeah. She's a good mom.
Yeah. There's a new documentary about Giannis. What do you know about it? I mean, you're kind of really in the mix there in Milwaukee with the Bucks and all the work you do. Is there any inside information you could give us?
Well, a few different angles. I know this documentary is the first like official feature length documentary on Giannis Antetokounmpo and his rise to the NBA's like stardom. I know that Disney did their version, which was like more of a narrative. WhatsApp did a 30-minute piece recently, and they did his homecoming to Nigeria. But this has a lot of Giannis's like nearest and dearest producers or contacts that became producers that work alongside him day in, day out, like agents, the photographer Nick Monroe for the Bucks, who I know and work with, I know pretty well. He's a great guy. He's worked with the Bucks in their media side of things for years and years, and now he kind of is like Giannis's right-hand man. He's one of the producers of the movie, so I feel like this is going to be a more intimate look into how he feels, like the psychology of him, where he comes from, where he draws his passion and competitive nature, I guess.
That's pretty cool. Yeah. It says it's directed by Kristen Lapis, who did, I hope I'm saying that right. She did some 30 for 30 documentaries. The film is called Giannis, The Marvelous Journey. I love that title. And it says it covers him from when he was on the streets of Athens all the way to becoming an NBA champion. I mean, when sports documentaries are done right, they're just great, you know?
And what better story than someone like Giannis Antetokounmpo and his family? You know,
I mean, from Africa to Greece to Milwaukee is so great.
You know, it's the pride of Africa today, like our taxi drivers from Ghana, you know, like Giannis Antetokounmpo is a global name and becoming a global like brand, I guess you could say, and pride of, you know, Nigeria where his family's from, but also Greece and Milwaukee, Wisconsin. We talk about Wisconsin being a great place to live. Who would have thought that this, you know, 8-time all-star, who's the team captain for the East, who's won the finals, had MVP back-to-back, he was a NBA all-star MVP, NBA champion, would stay in Milwaukee and raise a family.
And it's interesting that this is National Wisconsin Day, but I love that I have friends who are such huge Bucks fans and Giannis fans as a result. And one of them was so proud of the fact, and he told me this one day, he said he only owns property in Milwaukee. And I thought, whether that's true or not, I
think he has a place in Greece too now, but okay. You know, I could be mistaken. But no, I was able to work on a Nike shoot during the pandemic. And I had to go to Giannis's house and like, yeah, he lives in Milwaukee. He shops at Target with his now fiance and kids. He's goes to the state fair. Granted, as his rise to fame and like celebrity has gotten bigger, he does have like people around him.
Yeah.
You know, you don't just like go up and say hi to him necessarily sometimes, but most public settings, he's got like security detail now and people that handle him. But this story, what I thought was really interesting, there's two aspects of it. One is that he talks about how basketball for him is a way to get his family out of where they came from. You know, he saw it as a means almost to an end, just like that's why he plays, right? That's why he started playing. And then he also talks about how he nearly quit basketball when his father died.
Wow.
About 4 years ago, 5 years ago. And I was there that day. We were filming promos for the beginning of the season, which we do every October, which is all the stuff you see in-house, all the games, all the lighthearted things. And everyone is set up. We're talking like 40, 50 people. They have a company from LA come in to do all the motion graphics and animations. And the blue screens are up. There's several stations. You know, it's just a big day with a lot of Wisconsin cast and crew, I should say. And that's when we found out Giannis' dad passed away and they canceled the thing, you know. Jeez. And it was just a very somber day. It went from this very happy, like exciting day to a very somber moments, and no one knew kind of what was going on. Like, we were just told to be quiet. We were, they rescheduled it, but I just remember Giannis, the game after his father died, he had one of the best games of his career at that point.
Wow.
And he didn't quit. Thank God he didn't quit basketball, because you know what happened after that. And
right.
I think it's, and he always says he plays for his father's legacy. Like, he is his father's legacy.
It's so, did he move his whole family to Milwaukee? Like his mom, brothers and sisters. I know his brother plays too.
Yeah, two of his brothers play. Oh, I said three, I should say. Kostas plays, Alex plays in G League. Kostas was with the Lakers when they won the bubble championship in 2020. Right. And obviously Thanasis was drafted by the New York Knicks and now plays with Milwaukee. But all of his brothers, except for Francis, Francis is a brother that not many people know about. He stayed back in Nigeria when the kids were being raised in Greece. He actually played professional soccer.
Wow.
Francis is another brother, but he did move his entire family, except for Francis, to Milwaukee. That was part of the whole thing. That's why he was so loyal to the Bucks, is the Bucks made sure that, you know, the family made it over as well. So that game, that video I did, 10-year anniversary of his first start, a couple weeks prior to that was his first NBA game, and his parents were there to watch. That was a big thing. He wanted his parents there, so his mom and dad were in attendance with his little brothers.
That's
and her
so
pole
great.
At the time, the later pole.
What?
Talk about a Wisconsin, you know, legend.
Oh, yeah. And I just love that, like, Milwaukee's so different from Athens and Africa, and he's just kind of fallen in love with it. That's so cool. What is going on with that video? Can people, the one you made for the 10-year anniversary, that's the last time you were on here.
Well,
can we see it?
Yeah, it's on Twitter and Facebook. Unfortunately, in my line of work, I work in live sports television. So typically when things are seen, they're seen on television and they might be rerun once or twice. And then you have to find on social media. We're making something for the NBA and for like Bally Sports or Fox Sports or whomever. You know, they have certain like licensing and they can show things, whatever. I don't know how that works, but it's kind of out of my hands. But okay. You can watch it. I guess I could send you a link, but there is a link on Facebook where people could watch it. Now, my version of, well, my video celebrates his 10-year anniversary of his first start, but there's a lot of parallels in this. The trailer I saw for this movie that comes out on Monday on Amazon, the Marvelous Journey of Giannis. There's a lot of parallels to it because he's family first. You know, he's very close to his parents and his brothers. His mom lives, I don't know if she's still living with him, but she might still be living with him in a different wing of the house.
Wow.
But like she lived with him for years, even like playing, and they're always at the games and they have their own family suite and the brothers are there a lot of times.
That's so cool.
Still a very like parent-oriented man. And he's so close with his kids. I say just from seeing him with his children, whether it's a TV commercial or at the game, like he'll say like, hey, I want to spend another 15 minutes with my kids. He's got two boys and a daughter now. But he wants to be a very involved father. So yeah, I'm excited to see the movie. I haven't seen it.
If people want to see your video, where on Twitter or how on Facebook would they find it?
Well, if you go to like Bally Sports on Facebook, it came out on, it would have been
December, right?
November 18th. Okay. I have to look. The exact date. Okay. You can watch it there or on Twitter, Bally Sports, or I could send you a link. I don't know if you can link.
Yeah, we can post it. If you send me a link, we'll post it.
Send you a link.
Yeah, sure.
But yeah, I mean, Giannis is one of those guys when you talk about Milwaukee in Wisconsin that you like Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, or, you know, you have like Jordan Love, who knows what's going to happen with him, or you have like, I mean, there's really never been a Giannis before. Let's admit it. You know, you have this guy who pretty much comes from nothing.
Yeah.
And he becomes this international icon, and he's in Milwaukee. Like, of all markets, like, give me a break. I've got New York behind me right there.
Yeah,
there's the World Trade Center. You know how New York would love to have Giannis.
Oh, he could have gone anywhere, but yeah, it's so great that he stayed in
the money.
Yeah, and I don't think you have to worry. I don't think Jordan Love is going anywhere if the Packers have something to say
I'm just saying, like, yeah, Jordan Love, but you know. It's not often that you get like these MVPs like the Kareems or the Yeliches or the Giannises, but Giannis is just at another level. I mean, you can't even really compare him to another player. Maybe Kareem,
yeah,
because of what Kareem's done after and during his career.
Yeah. My guest is Brendan Jones. He is a filmmaker and does all kinds of cool video work for the Milwaukee Bucks. Do you have a new project in the works, Brendan?
Well, my dear friend Nick Summer, during the pandemic, wrote a movie that he'd been working on now for a few years, and I helped produce that. He just wrapped filming it, so he's in post-production with that. And it's not I didn't write it. I don't act in it, obviously, or anything like that, but I helped with, like, story editing, script editing, and then I produced it alongside of him. So he's a very creative talent. He's got things on like Amazon that you can watch, Shangri-La. He's made a couple films that he sold that you can watch streaming. He's just one of those guys that helps all of his friends in movies. He's helped a lot of like people do things that have blown up. He's done music videos. He's just a very talented person, but he's an artist first. He can do anything. Jack of all trades, carpentry, set design, prop master, art director. Wow. But he's a really great writer and a really good friend. So that's what I've been kind of working on. But a personal project, nothing in the works right now. I'm just helping him with his movie.
That's pretty cool. Well, you guys will have to come back when it's done and we can discuss it on the air.
Oh, yeah. You should definitely. Oh, Nick is a trip. Yeah. You would love Nick. And you might want to be in one of his upcoming projects.
Hey, why not? Absolutely. I'm a master thespian.
You still act, right?
I actually did about 3 films this past year. I've acted more since I moved to the Midwest. Really? Than when I was, I mean, I'm primarily hosting and I still write, but it's weird. It's mostly friends that say, hey, audition for this or whatever. It's not like I'm being sought out by the major studios.
That's kind of how it works, right?
Yeah, exactly. I'll take it. So you're a lifelong Wisconsin resident, correct?
Yeah. Yes. Born and raised. And then I've been in Milwaukee for about 22 years.
Okay. Favorite place in the state, favorite thing about Wisconsin?
Oh man, that's tough. There's so much I love, but I really genuinely going back to my childhood love going up to Door County in the nature.
Boy, Door County is kicking butt tonight. Yeah, Door, everybody is saying yeah, go ahead.
Well, our family, my mom and dad honeymooned there, and ever since I was a little boy, every year we go up there, and I love going to like the state parks, the beaches, walks. I just love the seasons. Not that we have many of those anymore. It's just cold and wet.
Right.
But my mom and I, during the pandemic, built a cabin up there hidden in the woods.
Oh my gosh.
So it's one of my favorite places to go and relax and look at the Milky Way. And, you know, it's like, it's a little spiritual for me at times, but other than that, I would say I definitely love Milwaukee summers. I don't know what beats a Milwaukee summer. It's just got so much to do. It's so fun. And, you know, it's relatively clean and affordable and easy to drive in. So I love Milwaukee in the summer.
That's a great answer, buddy. You obviously, your mom was obviously a great mom because you're very good to her. So good for you. And yeah, thanks for taking time out to talk to us tonight. Well,
thanks
really
for having me. It was
time.
A surprise. I was on the airplane today and I was like, yeah, I mean, I'll do this whenever you want. I love talking to Bucks. I love talking to Giannis. I love talking with you and anything that promotes the state of Wisconsin and the fine people that reside in it, right?
Oh, you're one of them, buddy. Thanks so much. Thanks for being on Nightlight. We'll do it again soon.
Oh, thank you.
That's Brendan Jones.
See you guys. Have a great night. Thank you.
Yeah, you bet. Calling us from the lobby of a hotel in New York. That is a dedicated guest right there. Okay, Conrad and I are going to talk more Wisconsin. That is coming up next as we celebrate National Wisconsin Day here on Nightlight with Peach Waba on the Civic Media Radio Network. Welcome back. We got a few more minutes here as we celebrate National Wisconsin Day. I want to thank my guest tonight, Logan Rogge from the Wisconsin Travel Office, joined us for a bit. I played an old excerpt of Adam West and my phone interaction that was a very awkward conversation we had, but I was happy to share that. I'll be sharing little tidbits of show business that I've experienced in my life and passing those along to you guys as a thank you for listening. Anya Esther joined me and Brendan Jones. We had a little Giannis talk. It's very interesting, Conrad, to me because today is Chris Farley's birthday.
Yeah.
He's a Wisconsin treasure, in my mm-hmm. opinion. And Giannis, another Wisconsin treasure, one from the world of entertainment, one from the world of sports. Both those worlds are entertainment, in my opinion. But it's just funny how that worked out on such a cool day for our state. We got another text here from the 818. Bridget says, I love Oshkosh. Leon's drive-in is iconic. Yes, it is.
It is.
Wow. That place... My wife loves that place. Her mom grew up in Oshkosh, and I have been going there since I've been dating her back in the early 30s. We've been together a long time, but not that.
You're revealing your age here, Pete, all right?
Yeah. I have nothing to hide. So you've been to Oshkosh? You've been to Leon's, Conrad?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that is good stuff.
I used to do basketball tournaments up there, and yeah, go to Leon's after or something.
Oh, nice. You know what you got to be careful, though, at Leon's? I learned this the hard way. The first time I bit into one of those, what do they call them, loose meat sandwiches? I know they're Sloppy Joes, but they have their own term for them, I think. But they are piping hot. And you got to be careful.
You couldn't wait?
Yeah. Like tear into this thing, ready to show it who's boss. And yeah, I couldn't do it. It burnt my tongue. But I still muscled through because I'm a gamer and I... brought my A game. So, hey, today also, so where is your favorite place in the state, Conrad?
My favorite.
Did I ask you this already?
Well, you did ask. Okay. I said Door County, but I also like going to Devil's Lake. It's really cool.
You did
going that. Up in the That's bluffs right. and stuff like that. It's really cool.
Do you? I want to share just a couple facts here. Okay, here's a couple fun facts on National Wisconsin Day. Nearly 21 million gallons of ice cream are consumed by Wisconsinites each year. That doesn't surprise me. No. I think we're one of the heaviest states, probably because we have so much great food here. But 21 million gallons of ice cream are consumed by Wisconsinites each year. You did not get, you thought Kohler was the toilet paper capital, right?
Yeah. It's the toilet capital.
The toilet. That's
the
right.
The toilet capital.
This might surprise you. Wisconsin is the leading producer of ginseng in the U.S.
Huh.
I didn't know that.
I didn't either.
Oh, my wife just sent me a text. And she said, juice burger. That's it.
Juice.
That's what they're called. That's good stuff. And we learned also from Logan Rogge, who is a Minnesota native but works for Travel Wisconsin now, that Wisconsin, even though Minnesota is the land of 10,000 lakes, Wisconsin has 5,000 more lakes than Minnesota. I'm typically not into these ridiculous provincial rivalries, but like, you can't call yourself the land of 10,000. I mean, it's not like they're lying. They have 10,000 lakes. We just have more. So rejoice, Wisconsin. Here's another fun fact. The Fox River is one of the few rivers in the nation that flows north.
Huh.
I had no idea.
I didn't either.
That's nuts. Wow. All right, one more. Let's see if we can find one more fun fact. Hey, you know what I want to do? This is, okay. So there were some birthdays we didn't get to. We can save a couple clips for tomorrow's show. But,
yeah.
Alex Borstein, it's her birthday. She plays Lois Griffin on Family Guy. We'll save those for tomorrow. But let's do this. It's Matt Groening's birthday. Did we play this yet?
We did not play.
You know, we did a pre-record. I'm all over the place. I can't remember who did what when. So Matt Groening's birthday is today. He turned 69. He created the comic strip Life in Hell, which became the TV show The Simpsons, which in my opinion is a gift to the world. It's one of the best satires ever made. Hilarious. And it's still funny. It's been on like 35 years. It is still funny. I don't think it's as funny as when it started, but it's an absolute treasure, and we have Matt Groening to thank for it. He is an executive producer on the TV show. I don't know how much input he has when it went to TV, but it's such a great show. We have a clip, and since the Super Bowl was just a few days ago, this is Homer Simpson betting on football, and he learns that Lisa, his daughter, is a genius when it comes to picking teams.
This team is fired up. We came here to play.
All right.
You'll lose.
What? Didn't you hear what he said?
Look at the fear in his eyes. Listen to the quiver in his voice. He's a little boy lost in a game of men.
You think we should bet against him?
I bet my entire college fund on it.
You got it. Mo, $23 on New York.
Start spreading the news. It's New York over Philadelphia, 35-10.
Yay! Yay!
Dad, I hate to break the mood, but I'm getting nauseous.
Oh, sorry. So, who do you like in the afternoon games?
Well, I like the 49ers because they're pure of heart. Seattle because they got something to prove. And the Raiders because they always cheat.
And in an extremely suspicious play, the Raiders win!
Woo-hoo!
That is such a great... There's a moment later in that same episode where the guy who's supposed to be Pat Summerall, the great announcer from the 70s and 80s, says... They show on the game Elway scoring a touchdown and spiking it. He says, thanks to John Elway's patented drive, the final score is Denver 14, San Francisco 56. And that was before the Broncos. They ended up winning two Super Bowls in Elway's career, but they were kind of a joke for a while when it came to the Super Bowl. Okay, Conrad, which city in Wisconsin is considered the bratwurst capital of the world?
Milwaukee?
No, I'll give you a hint. I wouldn't have gotten this either, but the name of the city is in the title or in the name of the product.
Johnsonville?
It's not Johnsonville. I know. That's probably where I would have gone to. Sheboygan.
Oh, so it's Sheboygan?
Sheboygan is the bratwurst capital of the world. How do you like that? And then also, last one, practically all the natural lakes in Wisconsin have resulted from glaciers. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know if people could hear that. It's National Wisconsin Day. Thanks for celebrating it with us. We had a great time tonight. Hope you did too. Hope you're back tomorrow night. We got Mike Clemens and Terry Barr and comedian Mike Mercury will be on the show. Thanks for joining me. This is Nightlight with Pete Schwabba on the Civic Media Radio Network. Happy Wisconsin Day and good night, Wisconsin.